How do you kill the Hydra? Well, the heads are an obvious starting point. Just as many cancer treatments aim to target the fastest growing cells, as these are the main burden of the disease. But, well, we saw that for Hercules, trying to kill off all the heads one by one didn't work so well. We need an approach that targets both the heads and the body of the Hydra. Because as long as the body survives, the heads can grow back. Cancer stem cells represent the body of the Hydra. These are rare cells within the tumor that are resistant to many forms of cancer treatment, such as chemo or radiation therapy. And they can regrow a tumor from a single cell. I'm focusing on prostate cancer in my thesis. It has a 30% 10-year mortality rate, which is largely due to recurrence of previously treated disease. Cancer stem cells can cause recurrence, so I'm looking to treat them with immunotherapy. Immunotherapy is already used to treat many forms of cancer, such as melanoma. This is because the immune system is capable of recognizing and killing cancer cells in the same way that it protects you from infections, such as viruses and bacteria. T cells are the assassins of the immune system. They can lock onto their target cell by interacting with proteins on that cell, recognize if it's mutated or infected, and kill it. However, at the moment, we don't know that much about cancer stem cells. So if I'm going to send my T-cell assassins on a mission to kill them, I have to find out more about them. I have to crack the genetic code, find out what genes are activated in cancer stem cells that makes them different from other cells within the tumor. I have to find out when they're acting suspiciously, such as repairing DNA damage inflicted by cancer treatments more efficiently than other cells within the tumor. To treat cancer stem cells in the clinical setting, we have to be able to distinguish them from other cancer cells and, of course, healthy cells. We have to be able to spot the difference. We can do this by investigating what proteins or combinations of proteins are expressed on the surface of cancer stem cells that aren't seen anywhere else, such as other cells within the tumor or ordinary cells. I've already done some work in this area, and I've successfully isolated cancer stem cells based on their unique protein profile. So I'm currently working on characterizing them further. The long-term future goal of my research would be the large-scale production of T cells for use in the clinical setting. This would form part of a combination approach in which the other cancer cells within the tumor are also treated, such as using chemotherapy or radiation therapy. This is because cancer is a battle that must be fought on all fronts. Kill the heads, kill the body, kill the Hydra.